A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. The Jews murmured about Jesus because he said, "I am the bread that came down from heaven." And they said, "Is this not Jesus, the son of Joseph? Do we not know his father and mother? Then how can he say, 'I have come down from heaven'?" Jesus answered and said to them, "Stop murmuring among yourselves. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draw him, and I will raise him on the last day. It is written in the prophets, 'They shall all be taught by God.' Everyone who listens to my Father and learns from him comes to me. Not that anyone has ever seen the Father except the one who is from God. He has seen the Father. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate the manna in the desert, but they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat it and not die. I am the living bread that comes down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world." The Gospel of the Lord. Good evening. I don't know about you, but I have these awful memories of grade school. There was always those basketball and dodgeball games when the gym teacher selected captains. Then the captains picked their teams. I don't know about you, but I was usually the last kid selected. I guess it was because of my amazing athletic ability. They were probably just afraid I would take their place as captain. But wow. The words of the gospel provide consolation for all of us who came here to share in the Lord's table. The Lord is surely pleased with all of us gathered here today, feeding our souls with Jesus in the Word and the Eucharist. In our gospel today, it is exactly what Jesus told us about. Jesus is calling us to come, eat and drink. He invites us to receive the sacrament of the Holy Eucharist and be sanctified with the power of the Holy Spirit. It is Jesus who is the bread that comes down from heaven so that you and I can live forever. Jesus knows that we have to live in the world, and he says, "Come and take me in so I can help you and teach you." He guides us to put aside the ways of the world. He works with us to eliminate the revenge, the bitterness, anger, hurt, and selfishness, as St. Paul's letter to the Ephesians explains. In my own words, the I comes first, changes with Jesus, and becomes the peacemaker for God the Father and one another. He changes the hard-hearted to live and become tender-hearted in causing us to love each other and forgive, as Jesus has taught us, and as each one of us wants God the Father to do with us. Jesus is well aware how the world can so easily harden us. It can harden us so we no longer hear the voice of the Holy Spirit that dwells inside of us. We become caught up in life, placing all our daily energies in trying to keep that I in us as number one, trying to replace Jesus and God the Father as the center of our lives. As we gather here and prepare to receive the real body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, let the sacrament begin its healing power. Let it begin to melt that hardening shell that has been built up because of our everyday lives. Prayerfully reflect in all three readings we heard today. Think about your week and take a good hard look at your life and allow the grace of God the Father to enlighten you. Let him enter your soul so you can see the world through his eyes, that forgiving and welcoming Father. Remember that each one of us was sealed with the Holy Spirit and claimed for Jesus at our baptism. It is through our baptism that we have been given the grace to hear God the Father calling us. He calls each one of us by our first name, directing us to Jesus, who is God's only begotten Son. Jesus is our way to the Father, our truth, and our life. We heard today in our gospel reading that no one can go to God the Father unless they go through Jesus. And in case you didn't notice, we profess this each Sunday when we recite the Creed. We restate at every Sunday Mass that we believe in Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. We also attest to our belief in the resurrection from the dead. Specifically, in the Creed, we state that we believe that Jesus will return each of us on the last day and transform us into his own likeness. Absolutely everything that God the Father does for each one of us is accomplished with the involvement of Jesus, God the Father, and the Holy Spirit, the Holy Trinity. And we all know that as Father consecrates the bread and wine at this table, our altar, they will be transformed into the real presence of Jesus, his body and blood. At that very moment, God the Father will also be physically present with us. It is in the consecrated bread and wine that we have the real presence of the Holy Trinity. I see it as Father lifts up the host and the chalice. The Holy Trinity is among us. So as we partake in the body and blood, we will be receiving the physical divine presence of God the Father, Jesus the Son, and the Holy Spirit. This meal we share is a meal of forgiveness, life and strength for each one of us. My brothers and sisters, believe in the words we heard from Jesus. Believe that the Holy Eucharist is the bread of life. Believe along with all our other sacraments, baptism, confirmation, anointing of the sick, marriage, holy orders, and reconciliation, that we are traveling along the way to eternal life, to live forever in the kingdom of God. The Eucharist is the new bread of heaven for our souls, making each one of us new again.